Now, these are the supplies and tools that you will need when you start converting your paper pattern into a garment that you can fit. When you're working with this fitting garment, think of it as like scratch paper. It's not something you're going to necessarily want to wear outside. What I like to use, what a lot of people will use for these fittings, is this cotton muslin. It's fairly inexpensive. This is a slightly heavier weight, which I get from Chicago Canvas, which I'll have a link to that. But when you're fitting using the techniques that I'll be showing you, which are designed for fitting techniques for people who have never fitted before, we're going to use the grain of the fabric to see exactly the shape of the darts and the position of the side seams. Well, I don't think you can probably see which direction the grain is. I mean, this has been ripped here, so obviously that's one direction for the grain, and this has been ripped down here, so that's another direction for the grain. But if you're trying to determine the grain in the middle of this, it's very hard to do. I used to go around with a magnifying glass in my initial pattern design class, trying to show people where the grain was, and then one day I dropped into a fabric store and I saw this. Now, I think probably even at a distance you should be able to see which way the grain of this fabric is going. It's woven directly into it. Be sure you get gingham for this initial fitting of the bodice and the skirt, and the upper torso, the lower torso. Make sure you get it that has the same pattern on both the front and the back. There are places that will actually sell the gingham printed onto regular fabric. You want the gingham actually woven into it, and this will tell us when our fabric is being shaped correctly. For the skirt and pants, you might want to have a zipper handy. If you were using a zipper for your sewing machine, you'll need a zipper foot. You can do a lot of the fitting and sewing by hand, but the sewing machine is a little helpful. I'm not going to show you the sewing machine. I think you all know what a sewing machine looks like. But also iron and an ironing board. Be sure you keep that handy. Now, when you're actually doing the sewing of this gingham, don't worry about getting a lot of colored threads. I mean, just have a basic white and a basic black. That's really all you need for most of the pattern initial testing that we'll be doing. You'll need a needle for doing some hand basting, and you'll need pins for preparing the garments when sewing, and we'll be showing you all of this and techniques in the various videos. We'll also be using, especially for the do-it-yourselfers, these bias tapes for helping hands, as it were, as you're doing the fitting. Now, we talked about the paper scissors earlier. Here are two versions of fabric scissors. This one's kind of nice for the short, and this is kind of nice when you're making long cutting strokes. You can cut using pins and scissors, or you can cut using a rotary cutter, which pops out the blade. Make sure you keep that blade in when you're not using it. And what you do is you actually will cut right on a cutting mat, and thus keeps self-healing mat. Another technique that we will be showing you in videos on how to prepare fabric is to use a cork board. This cork board allows you to take a pattern and stick it right onto the fabric and then punch those pins in, and it's a very quick way to lay out. The thing I like about it is you can make sure your grain is aligned to the corners of the board, and this is a technique that I started using in theater where you're cutting out a lot of large garments very quickly. Now, one of the tools that you might want to have is a pattern notcher. The pattern notcher actually allows you to transfer sewing notches from your pattern onto, you can cut through both the fabric and the thing by just a notch. You get a very controlled notch. It's like 3/16 of an inch. It's not even a quarter of an inch. 3/16 of an inch by 1/16 of an inch wide, and it's a very convenient notch to align your patterns when you start sewing it. But generally, for your initial patterns, you don't need to be that concerned about a pattern notcher. Now, I wish I could say you don't need this, but you do. The seam ripper. Okay, we're going to be taking out some of the seams that we sew. And then once you have completed your initial fittings, you're going to want to transfer it back on. As you're doing the fitting, you have the option of marking things with pins. I'll show you how to mark them with pins, but once you've marked them with pins, you've got the garment off, you're going to want to transfer, make those marks a little more durable because you're going to need to pull the pins out. So you might want to use like the Marks Be Gone that's used in the sewing industry, or you will see us actually using the Sharpie marking. As you're fine-tuning your patterns, you're going to need what's called a tracing wheel and tracing paper. Our final tool in verifying and adjusting the fit is a camera. I'll be showing you in videos how you can use a camera to verify you've got an accurate fit. The nice thing by looking at a camera, if you take it from the right angle, you can take a look at those pictures and say, oh, I should have had that dart the quarter of an inch larger. Or you can show it over the internet and other people will be able to comment on the accuracy of your fittings.